morning. In case you haven't read or noticed, we're going to do things a little bit different this morning. As you notice, there's a convention going on, and we're a little short on pastors in the area. So pastor set up this service. It is not a divine service, but everything should be printed in your bulletin. So bear with us. We're going to try this for the first time. So our first hymn this morning is going to be 842. We'll start this service with the ringing of the bells.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We continue with the introit. Your word is a lamp to my feet,
and a light to my path.
The Lord is my portion. I entreat your favor with all my heart.
Be gracious to me according to your promise.
When I think on my ways,
I turn my feet to your testimonies.
I hasten and do not delay.
To keep your commandments.
The earth, O Lord, is full of your steadfast love.
Teach me your statutes.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Your word is a lamp to my feet,
and a light to my path.
You may be seated. We'll continue with 461. Let us pray together the collect of the day. O Lord, grant us the Spirit to hear your word and know the one thing needful, that by your word and Spirit we may live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We continue with hymn 720.
The Old Testament lesson for this sixth Sunday after Pentecost is found in the book of Genesis, the 18th chapter. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the oaks of Mamre as he sat at the door of his tent in the heat of the day. He lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, three men were standing in front of him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them and bowed himself to the earth and said, O Lord, if I have found favor in your sight, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought, and wash your feet, and rest yourselves under the tree, while I bring a morsel of bread that you may refresh yourselves. And after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant. So they said, Do as you have said. And Abraham went quickly into the tent to Sarah and said, Quick, three seahs of fine flour. Knead it and make cakes. And Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to a young man who prepared it quickly. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, "Where is Sarah, your wife?" And he said, "She is in the tent." The Lord said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah, your wife, shall have a son." And Sarah was listening at the tent door behind him. Now Abraham and Sarah were old, advanced in years. The way of women had ceased to be with Sarah. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, "After I am worn out and my Lord is old, shall I have pleasure?" The Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Shall I indeed bear a child now that I am old?' Is anything too hard for the Lord? At the appointed time, I will return to you about this time next year, and Sarah shall have a son." This is the word of the Lord. We continue with our next hymn, hymn number 595.
The epistle is from Colossians chapter 1. "You who once were alienated and hostile in mind, doing evil deeds, he has now reconciled in his body of flesh by his death, in order to present your holy and blameless and above reproach before him. If indeed you continue in the faith, stable and steadfast, not shifting from the hope of the gospel that you heard, which has been proclaimed in all creation under heaven, and of which I, Paul, became a minister. Now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in Christ's afflictions, for the sake of his body, that is the church, of which I became a minister, according to the stewardship from God that was given to me for you, to make the word of God fully known. the mystery hidden for ages and generations, but now revealed to his saints. To them God chose to make known how great among the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we proclaim, warning everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone mature in Christ. For this I toil, struggling with all his energy that he powerfully works within me. This is the word of the Lord. We continue with the next hymn 566.
Thank you. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 10th chapter. Now they went on their way. Jesus entered a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. And she had a sister named Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teachings. But Martha was distracted with much serving, and she went up to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Tell her then to help me." But the Lord answered her, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things, but one thing is necessary. Mary has chosen the good portion, which will not be taken away from her." This is the gospel of the Lord. We continue with our next hymn, 537. Please rise as we confess our faith to Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell.
The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated. We continue with our next hymn, 736.
Thank you. 7:22.
We continue now with the prayers of God's people. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the good gifts of God in all creation, everything that we need to support us in body and life, let us pray to the Lord. For the spiritual blessings of God, for the forgiveness of sins and newness of life that comes from the gospel of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For faithful pastors, teachers, and missionaries, for the proclamation of the Word of God in all the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Pastor Honaki and for all those attending the convention this week, that their work may be done to the glory of God and for the good of the church, let us pray to the Lord. For our families, for faithful husbands and wives, responsible fathers and mothers, and obedient children, let us pray to the Lord. For all those in authority over us in the church, in civil government, and in our homes, let us pray to the Lord. For all those who serve in the armed forces, in law enforcement, in disaster relief, and as first responders, let us pray to the Lord. For all people in their particular vocations, that they may continue in their good work in love of God and in service to their neighbor, let us pray to the Lord. For favorable weather and for the fruitfulness of the earth, let us pray to the Lord. For all those who are sick or hospitalized, for our shut-ins, for anyone suffering any distress of body or soul, let us pray to the Lord. For the family of Gary Nurnberger as they mourn his passing, Heavenly Father, into whose keeping we entrust our loved ones, help us to look to you in our time of sorrow, remembering the cloud of faithful witnesses with which we are surrounded. Grant that we may one day share in the joys of those who now rest in your presence. Let us pray to the Lord. Finally, for those and for all our needs of body and soul, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. And we continue together with Luther's morning prayer. I thank you, my heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil one may have no power over me. Amen. We now continue with our next hymn. Thank you.
We rise for the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless us, defend us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We close with hymn 922.
I want to thank everybody for being here. I hope this hymn sing again has brought some good songs out that everybody enjoyed. I personally enjoyed every one of them. As you heard in prayers, Gary Nurnberger has passed away. His visitation will be at Lessman Koch Funeral Home on Tuesday, July 23rd from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. and 1 hour prior to the service. The funeral will be here at Trinity on Wednesday, on the 24th at 11 p.m. Or a.m., I'm sorry. Yeah, I don't think anybody wants to come here that late. Also, as most of you know, we had a a barbecue yesterday, and we do have some pork sausage, lard, and blood sausage left over that they will be serving. Arville Heller, Arville and Denise Heller will be having it in the back of their vehicle. So they're going to be serving out of that. And also refreshments will naturally be served again out in the front lawn. And I just want to, on behalf of the rest of the elders, it was an honor to do this service for you. I hope you all enjoyed it. Is there any other announcements to be made? Are there any other? Tim?
I just want to remind everybody that this board meeting following the church next Sunday. All committee members are busy. They're going to be teachers, so we'll have to list the teachers for everybody to vote on and hopefully we'll get things going.
Okay, thank you. Any other announcements? Everybody have a good week. Thank you.